Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the next videos on Kotlin tutorials, and in this case we will talk about lambdas. If you just try to search about lambdas, this is what the documentation throws up. It basically says that Kotlin functions are first class, and basically you can treat functions as variables, objects, or reference types. And one of the common term that you will also keep hearing as far as lambdas are concerned is that they say they are higher order functions. So basically saying that you can write a function that takes a function as a parameter and returns a function. Well, it can be really confusing to imagine a function like that. But let's try to break it down and understand it in simple terms. Let's assume that this is the function that we have. It's an add function that takes two arguments and then returns a sum of those two numbers. Now, I can write this in a slightly different way using the syntax of the lambdas. And if I do that, this is how it looks. It can look a bit confusing, but it's not that complicated. It still has the same things, but slightly in a rearranged manner. The add has been declared with a val keyword. So basically now add is not a function, it is a thing that is being treated like a variable. So that is the main difference that you will observe now. And that is the name of the lambda. And then in front of that name of the lambda, you have type of the lambda. Type is nothing but signature of the lambda. And then you have the body, the actual code that does something with whatever the arguments that you are passing. The only extra thing that you are seeing here is the argument list. You need this to basically deal with the data that you are passing to the lambda, because just based on the type, you don't have the variables to deal with in the body. Other than that, this looks pretty much simple. So let's try to do a couple of demos and see how actually it works. So if you see here, right now we have a add function, and now we have declared two number values, and this is something that you have been doing for quite a long time now. But now instead of doing this, we will write a lambda function. How do we do that? Let me write a val add, then I have to give the type, that is it takes two arguments of type int and then returns a int equals to then a variable which is of type int, the variable which is of type int, and then the arrow sign, finally giving us the body which is a plus b, and that's it. And if you see here, the way I invoke remains the same, nothing has changed, and if I run this, I still get the same result. And this is what this lambda function is. Instead of val, if I try to do var, that also is still perfectly fine. So that is what it is. Now you have basically created a function that is being treated like a variable. This is one way of writing lambda, but there is even much smaller way of writing lambda. Right now, since you are already giving the type as two int arguments and returning an int, you can actually skip this. And this is also a perfectly valid way of writing a lambda. You can see that it is not throwing up any compile time error. And what you can also do is, if you don't want to write the type, you can emit it, but in that case you have to give the data type, and then the return type int is automatically inferred by the compiler. You don't have to declare the return type is also int, because you are passing int and then you are adding them, and of course it is going to be an int. So this is just another way of writing the lambda, which you can call it as a shorthand notation of writing a lambda. And to invoke, nothing changes. It pretty much remains same. Of course, there is another way you can invoke this. That is, instead of writing add num1, num2, I can write something like add invoke num1, num2. And that also pretty much does the same thing. There is absolutely no difference that invoke does. However, there are some advantages of using invoke in certain cases, which we will talk about in future. So that's it about the initial introduction to Lambdas. We will explore this in a much more deeper manner in the upcoming videos. So take care. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.